Welcome back to the Seriously Serious Show. I am your host, The Pels. I am here with Paige to my right, but I am also here with the one, the only, George Moss, everybody.
I'm glad to be here.
Yeah, I can hear you. How you doing, George?
I'm doing great, man. Look at you guys in the new studio. Man, it's looking fantastic in there.
Yeah, look at you, though, man. You've changed a little bit since the last time we've talked. I think there is... What is on your finger?
There's some bling.
Oh, man, I got married on Friday. Crazy, right?
Yes. Congratulations.
Yay. Thank you, man. I appreciate it.
Now, you said it was going to be a huge party. How'd the party go? What was it like? What was going on?
It was just that. It was a party, man. We had, it was about 300 people came out, and we had like a dance floor, disco ball, pinata, the DJ, lights and stuff going everywhere. And like, I actually had not kissed my wife up until our first kiss at the altar, or on the dance floor, I should say, that day. So like when we had our first kiss, we had like these big cryojet smoke things go off and everybody threw confetti. It was just a big celebration, man. It was a lot of fun. I got the videos on Facebook and all that too, so check it out there.
So your first kiss with her wasn't until the wedding? Until the wedding dance? Because I saw the picture of it and I was like, I guess that's the first kiss of them being married.
Yeah.
Of being married. But no. This is your first kiss ever.
Well, I mean, I kissed her like on the cheek, on the forehead and stuff like that. First kiss on the lips. Like that was.
That's
oh, wow.
Very first kiss.
Now, I don't need to go too in depth, but like, was it was it just crazy? Like on your end, I'm sure it was amazing. Was she excited with it? Because that's a nerve wracking thing. It's one thing for me because I'd be like, woo! And for guys, it's awesome. For the girls, it's like, not as good as I expected.
I just hope my breath didn't stink. Either way, she was very gracious about it.
So she was gracious.
She liked it. I thought it was fantastic, personally.
So you loved it, but you hoped that your breath didn't stink.
Exactly.
Yes. And
pop some gum.
Yes. Hopefully you brushed your teeth beforehand. But that's an amazing story because you do not hear that in this day and age at all. Was there any reasoning behind it? Is that just something you guys decided to do together?
Actually, well, it's something that we decided to do together, but it's like I didn't know that that was her standard when I first met her, like until we actually discussed it and talked about it. But I got it from my youth pastor when I was a kid. Like that was the way he wanted to show his wife that he loved her, was to not kiss her until the wedding, until the altar. So I just kind of got it from him. It wasn't an original idea. I was like, man, that is a great plan, great idea. So that's what we did. We were like, I'm not going to have a first kiss until we go to the altar and kiss it in front of everybody and say, hey, this is forever. This is my last first kiss that I'm going to have.
Well, congratulations. That is awesome. I am glad that you two had that special moment. Now, how'd you bowl? Like, did you bowl that night or were you going around with everyone shaking hands or what was your plan?
Well, see, the thing, yeah, so after the party, if you didn't know, after the party is the after party.
And
we went out to the bowl. We rented out the entire bowling alley and had all the guests come over there to bowl with us for the night. Needless to say, I cut out a little bit early, but we did. I bowled a little bit, but my head wasn't in the bowling game that night. I think I maybe bowled like a 37 or something. I don't know. I was more so hanging out with everybody else and saying what's up.
That is understandable that you probably had bigger plans for the night hanging out with your wife. And that's awesome. And it's amazing. It's a good thing. I think so many times as Christians, we don't think that's like an okay topic to talk about. I think it's all right. You and your wife waited for the first kiss and you guys waited for each other, that special moment. And just that bond for between you two. And I think that's amazing and great. And I'm very proud of you, proud of the situation. And hope it just continues to grow and blossom.
Yeah, so. Man, tell you what, marriage is wonderful. I highly recommend it to people that, like, know what love is in Christ and in Jesus, you know? So.
Cool. awesome. Now, I know Paige saw this picture on your Instagram, and she had this quite, and I saw it, and
no, and she, I like threw up in my mouth a little. Can I just tell you? I did. Tell us a little bit about the bacon out of a squeeze bottle.
Man, now, this bacon thing has gone way too far. Like, this, it seems like everybody has been talking about bacon for, like, the past year. Like, there's bacon everything. I went to the Yankee Candle store last Father's Day, and there was a bacon candle. And I thought that that was just gross. Like, who? I mean, no, I'm not going to lie. The smell of bacon can smell pretty good when it's bacon. But, like, I personally don't even eat bacon. So, I'm not hating on the people that eat bacon. But I'm just saying, like, okay, I can understand the smell of bacon may sound good, but in a candle, that's pushing it. But when you have to get to the point where you put it in a squeeze bottle like ketchup, that's just crossing the line. That's offensive to
as nasty.
To just human beings in the first place. Like, I'm ashamed to be an American today to know that people eat that in our country. Like, that's just ridiculous. It's bacon.
And you know someone went out to pick that up. Like, you know someone went out, hey, I got to go to Target to pick up some bacon.
Oh, gosh. That, just the thought of it, it's just like, I don't even know if it's real. It's one of those things that's on the internet. I pray to God it's not real, because whoever is eating that is definitely in deep, deep sin right now. And they need to repent and turn from their ways.
I don't know if they're in deep, deep sin because they eat bacon, ketchup. We might have to test our theology on that one, but I see where you're going with it. There's a possibility of you know, some sin, but not deep, deep sin, you know? Well,
if you're eating bacon out of a squeeze bottle, there's some issues going on in your life.
Well, I think next Monday, me and you need to get like a bacon bottle and see how much we can like just squeeze down in our mouth and see who can hold it in the most. I want to take you down in the competition.
I succeed. You win already.
So this will be probably the first thing you've ever lost at. Am I correct?
No. I don't lose. I still didn't lose. I'm not gonna play.
Oh, okay. I see. You're taking your ball home and you're just going out. You're just leaving. You're not even gonna try to play. So
I'm going home.
Taking your ball and going home. So what else has been going on with you? You've been, you got a bunch going on. I see that money's starting to come in. And I realized today I was giving money away to you today, but I had to sign in. I messed up. But can you tell people where to go so they can continue to give you this funds for another CD?
Well, here's the thing. It's like I went and started this new project. Now, I'm telling you guys about this for the past couple of weeks, but the Indiegogo campaign started last week, which, by the way, was a stupid idea. Don't launch an Indiegogo campaign and get married in the same week. Dumb idea. Really, really dumb idea. But I did launch the Indiegogo campaign last week, and it's off to a good start. I mean, it's for the fact that I haven't been able to really focus on it, and I've been really preoccupied with doing some other things, with marriage and all that stuff. But you can go to my Facebook page or go to Indiegogo.com. Just search George Moss. You'll see the project up there. The goal is to raise $30,000 in 60 days to complete my next record. And it's a huge goal. And like, everybody needs to be involved in order for us to get to this goal. Like, it's not necessarily the amount of money that you put up. It's just the fact to say, hey, man, I got your back. I want to hear my music. And it's anywhere from, I mean, $1, $5, $10, whatever it may be. I mean, if you want to give $100 or $200 or $3,000, $5,000, it's totally up to you. But even at just $1, just to say, hey, look, I'm supporting you. I'm going to get behind you, and I really want to see you make this next record. That means a ton to me, just to see how many people are supporting. So you go to Indiegogo.com search for George Moss. You can do that there. See all the different campaigns or all the different package levels. I got a bunch of cool rewards where I'm one of the rewards, I could do a private concert at your house with all your friends. I got a pass on there where you can get free tickets to any George Moss show ever for life. I mean, no matter how big or small I stay, how big I get, if I'm selling out arenas one day, I'm giving you tickets to every single show that you want to come to forever. And there's all sorts of other cool stuff in there that I'm offering as far as t-shirts, posters, phone calls. I'll shout you out on Twitter. I'll follow you back on Instagram. Any of those things are all in there. So check out the Indiegogo campaign. Would love to have your support. I need your support in order to make this next record because I can't make it without you. So you can find it there.
No, that's perfect. I totally agree with it only starts with $1.
Yeah.
And if you can do that, if you want more music from George Moss, go out there, spend just a couple of seconds, and give $1 to help him out. And if you know of others, and if it continues to add up, that's how cool movements start. That's how we can help George Moss out. It might be one, it might be five, it might be 10. Just you can just start out and just start by giving one. So let's continue to do that and tell your friends about it. And it's definitely, like you said, it's definitely hard to get married and push this at the same time. And so now it's sort of cool that you get this process of now, okay, let's jump all the way in and let's do this for the next 60 days and let's just go as hard as we can and then let's do it. So I'm excited to see what happens and just that you've had a good start. And hopefully we can continue to move forward with that.
Sweet, man. I don't know if you're talking about the marriage or the Indiegogo campaign.
But everything. Way, both. I'm talking about your marriage and Indiegogo. I'm talking about it both. Just keep going. Just keep pushing forward. Just keep on loving. Keep on caring.
Keep on keeping on.
Yeah, just keep on keeping on. All right. So, no. I am glad I can make you laugh a little bit, George. I am glad you could take time out of your Monday schedule and hang out with us.
Yeah, definitely, man. I can't wait till next Monday, man. This is my favorite part of the week.
Awesome. I'm glad. And I can't wait until you are in the studio so I can finally compete against you like we are meant to compete.
Oh, we're going to make it happen.
Oh, yeah, we are. I'm sick of you holding it over my head. That's why you keep on taking your ball and going home. Okay. It is time to compete.
All right, let's do it.
All right, awesome. We'll talk a little bit during break about when maybe that can happen. But congratulations on being married. Congratulations on the next steps of your life. We love you here at the Seriously Serious Show. So keep on keeping on.
Love you guys too. Right there.
Thanks, George. And to all of you guys, we got some more music. Paige is with us. We got so much more coming. We're going to do a little skit next. Mm-hmm. And then we got some time with Paige. It's Paige. It's going to be a full show with you for the next hour and so. So here's 21 Pilots, Guns for Hands.